guys, welcome to my channel. I hope you all are doing great. It is Saturday afternoon and I just came back from Costco. Man, it was a madhouse. I was actually gonna record inside, show you guys how it is, because I actually went to Costco after many months. I don't even remember last time when I went there, because last couple of times I ordered, it was online, so physically I did not go there. And today the reason I had to go there is because I had a Costco gift card and somehow they will not take the gift card online. So physically you had to go there and use it. So that was the only reason I had to go. Otherwise I would not even go there because it was a pack. There were so many people were there. And I reached there actually a few minutes before they were opening. And as soon as I went there, I saw like there was a huge line out there. So first of all, I was like, forget about it. I'm not gonna stand in this line. I'll just come some other time. But then line kind of started moving very quickly. So I was like, okay, fine. Because it doesn't matter what time you go to Costco. There is always many people there and there is always the line, right? So I went there, got a few things. I'll show you what I bought. Some cups as well as the paper plates. And I was actually looking for the organic sugar, but they didn't have that, so I just got this one. Also got some garbage bags as well as the dishwasher detergent, and here I have this laundry detergent. And try this mango nectar juice. I would highly recommend, do try it. It is very tasty. And I was thinking about making sandwich, so I got this bread. I also bought this tiramisu, so whenever I go there and if I can find this, I always buy it because it is so tasty. And this container, it is made of glass, so I always save this container too. I also bought this salad mix, and the reason I like this kind of pre-mixed salad thing is because it has everything in it. So it has the dressing and all the toppings and everything, so you don't have to worry about anything. And Wegmans also has this, but they have the smaller bag. And Costco, as you can see, this is huge, so it's good for four of us. I also got this spinach and cheese ravioli. Now this is the different than what I bought last time. So the one that I got it last time, that was like triangle shape, and it also comes with some spices and herbs mixed in it. So once you are done boiling, you can sprinkle that on top, and that actually tastes so good. But I couldn't find that one, so I bought one of this. Without fail, I always buy this smoothie mix from Costco because it has all the different berries as well as kale, spinach and banana. So all I need is the almond milk to make my smoothie. I also bought this Pepperidge Farm dark chocolate cookie. They are so good, and the good thing about them is they are packed like this individually, so if your kids are going back to school, then it's easy for you to pack for their lunch. And also, if you haven't tried this popcorn chips, I would highly recommend that you try it. They are so good. And out of all this, especially my favorite is the sweet and salty kettle corn one. Man, it is so good. And yes, I also got this Rao's pasta sauce. Now, I actually like their roasted garlic one, but of course Costco doesn't have all the varieties, and this is the first time actually I saw it at the Costco because I had never seen this one before over there. And I was hoping to find ginger over there because many of you always say that they have organic ginger, but at my Costco I never find it. And today also specifically I went and checked everywhere. I asked one of the employee over there too, and they say no, we don't carry the ginger, because I just have a little bit left. So I was hoping that if I can find it over there, that's good, but most probably I might have to go to Wegmans tomorrow to get it. And that's it. So that's all I got it from Costco. And many of you ask me about this bracelet because whenever I'm cooking, you know, you guys always see that this bracelet is always on my right hand side. So this one is actually from India, and it is a diamond bracelet. Mom got it last time when we went in 2012, so she made this entire set for me. So bracelet, I do have the necklace as well as the earrings, and I wish I can link this for you guys, but it is a custom made So every time mom used to go to India, because, you know, the gold thing now we don't wear that much, right? Unless there is some kind of occasion or something. Otherwise, I like the diamond because then I can wear it with my Western outfit or Indian outfit, doesn't matter. You know, it goes with everything. So whenever she used to go, she always used to get this diamond sets for me. So this one is the last one in 2012 when they were there and we also went there. So that time she made this set for me. So for that reason, I always wear this bracelet because that is the last thing from mom. So ye meri yaadgiri hai mom ki. For lunch, I'm making kanda bhajia, and for that I'm using this chopped onion. You do want to make sure that it's finely chopped. If you don't want to use the chopped onion, you can always use the sliced onion also. Also adding besan as well as the rice flour. Now rice flour will make pakoda extra crispy, and now I'm gonna add some salt to taste and the basic masala. So a little bit of hing, that is the asafoetida, haldi powder, red chili powder, and this is totally optional, but I would highly recommend that you add it, and that is the green chilies. After adding the green chilies, I'm gonna add some oil into this, and then we're gonna mix all this with the hand. After mixing all this properly, now I'm gonna start adding water to this, and when you add the water, again, you do want to add just a little bit first and not add too much, because onion ooze out some water anyway. So with this pakoda, you just have to be careful and not add too much water. After I add the water into this, I'm gonna let that stay for about 15-20 minutes, and then once the oil is hot enough, we're gonna go ahead and deep fry it. So when you are ready to deep fry this, at that time only you do want to add just the pinch of baking soda, just the pinch, not more than that. And that's it. Then we're gonna go ahead and deep fry this pakoda. Definitely you do want to try this recipe, because I tried one pakoda, it came out so good. And that green chili that I added in there, so I would say don't skip on green chili. If you don't want it like spicy, then just add a little bit of red chili powder, don't add too much, but don't skip the green chili. Because of that, actually it tastes really good. So what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna let this cool down completely first, and then after that we're gonna press it with the bowl, and we're gonna make it flat, and then again I'm gonna fry it. So once I fry the second time, then it will be nice and crispy, and uske saath bas main chai bana dungi, kyunki seem like it's gonna rain any minute now. So ye aur chai ka combination hai, to bas aur kuch nahi chahiye. And I used to make this pakoda before a lot, but I don't know, lately I haven't made it. So today I was like, let me go ahead and make this. Actually, my husband was saying that just don't make anything, you know, because we got salad and all that. So he's like, we'll just eat that. I was like, nay, you know, kyunki, as I mentioned earlier, I'm not like a pakoda person. The only pakoda that I like is the onion one and the green chili one, and that's about it. I don't like the potato or banana or anything like that. But I'm also making the aloo pakoda as well as the kele ka pakoda. तो उसके लिए मेरे पास यहाँ पे रेगुलर जो हम उसका बनाते हैं ना, वो बेसन है इसमें, जस्ट रेगुलर मसाले और कुछ नहीं है इसमें, क्योंकि वो मेरे हस्बैंड को पसंद है. और ये जो केले का पकोड़ा है ना, वो मेरे हस्बैंड और राज दोनों को पसंद है, तो दैट्स व्हाट आई एम गोना मेक. बट व्हेनेवर यू मेक दिस केले का पकोड़ा ना, तो ऑलवेज वेट अंटिल यू आर डन मेकिंग अदर पकोड़ा. लाइक इफ यू आर मेकिंग जस्ट लाइक मी, राइट, मेकिंग द ओनियन और द आलू पकौड़ा, देन जस्ट वेट अंटिल यू आर डन मेकिंग ऑल ऑफ देम एंड देन डीप फ्राइड. बिकॉज उसमें क्या होता है कि एज सून एज यू डीप फ्राई द केले का पकौड़ा ना,
ये जो ऑयल है ना, इट somehow like because of the kela and all that, right? It become black. So then you can reuse it. And many of you also ask me that how many times I use my oil. So I use maybe one or two times. And that is also again depend what I'm deep frying. So in this case, I deep fry the onion, right? So of course the smell is gonna be in there. So now this is it. Now I'm not gonna use this anymore. Once I'm done with making this pakoda, then that's it. I'm not gonna reuse it. But let's say I made puri, just regular puri or just a regular aloo pakoda or something, then I use it second time. So it's all depend, but I don't use it that many times. And also, I always get the question about where I bought this frying pan. So this actually, again, mom bought it. There was a Indian store in Florida, so she bought it from there, and I have this from many years, but still it's in perfect condition. I don't have any problem with it. So I don't think so. I try to see if I can find it on Amazon, but I haven't found this one. But I would say if you are looking for something like this, then definitely try your local Indian store, because some Indian store do carry this. So now I'm just gonna wait until this cool down, and that's it. That will be our lunch. So we are done with the lunch. I just need to clean a little bit here. But before I end this video, let me show you my bracelet. So this one is from Style & Art. And what it is that you buy the band, and this band is reversible. And then you buy this charm. Again, they have many options for the charm. So I thought, let me start first with this and see how it's gonna be. But I really like it. So maybe down the road, I'll buy more charms. It is something different, so I'm gonna link it down below in the description box. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'm gonna end this vlog here. I hope you guys have enjoyed today's vlog. Take care, and I will see you soon in my next video.